Sage Wonder coming at you from my hideout on the hill. So I wanted to talk to you today about a dream that I had the other night. Actually, it's been over a week ago that I had this dream, and I've been meaning to make a video about it, but I've been so busy. But I wanted to go back and share this dream with you. I have very clear memory of the dream, and I find the dream very interesting, and I'm curious what you guys think that it means or the significance of it. And it's definitely kind of a religious dream, I guess, but not like any religious kind of imagery I've ever heard of before. But let me just tell you what I saw in this dream. In this dream, I was in a heavenly courtroom, and it was kind of interesting because it very much mirrored a courtroom of today. It looked a lot like a courtroom of today, except the room was huge. It wasn't a room at all. It was almost like it was outdoors, as it were. But it was definitely a court in heaven, and God presided over it. Now, what did God look like? I could not see him. He was a glowing essence who I was aware that the essence of God was listening and judging, and that mandates would be issued and orders followed after the verdict. And what was being argued was whether or not civil war would be permitted in the United States, whether the wholesale blood spilling of millions of Americans would be allowed under God's eye, let's put it that way, in God's sight. And so there was a prosecuting attorney that I assumed was the devil, but I do not know. And he was really the essence of a combination of a slick politician and a used car salesman and a prosecuting attorney. And he was very flashy and flamboyant and persuasive, extremely persuasive. And he was arguing the case and the position of God. On God's side, I guess, the godly side, was a group of 12 angels. And these angels all sat stoically. And sometimes they spoke in unison as one voice. And other times individual angels would stand up and speak. And the strongest imagery I have for the prosecutor, the demonic, satanic prosecutor, is that when it was his turn to talk, he would leap over the table in front of him in one bound. He was just, instead of walking around the table and approaching, he would just leap over it. And the whole time that he was presenting the case, he was like a pitch man. It was like he was a pitch man. It reminded me of, some like a ShamWow kind of thing. And anyway, it was meant to persuade the opinions of the heavenly court, because the court was filled with people and angels. What did the angels look like? Ethereal creatures. They were perfect and stoic and expressionless, and to some degree genderless, but yet masculine, but not like bearded or anything. And the thing that stunned me the most is how they would speak in unison. It was just kind of weird. It was just weird that they would all speak at the same time and make this harmonious kind of sound as they spoke. And so the satanic, demonic prosecutor was making the case why Americans want civil war, and why we have to give them free will, and we have to permit them to kill each other because that's what they all want. And then he would play video, as it were. It was actually like a hologram that would just appear in the room of individuals screaming for civil war on both sides. Antifa crying for an overthrow, the deep state threatening to kill the president, and people on the right going, come and get it, bring it on, we're going to come after you, and we want this, we're tired of it, we're going to purge the nation of all these people. And the other side saying, we're going to purge the nation of all these people. And the demonic prosecutor was arguing that this is what all of the American people wanted. And then he was forced to sit down, and his turn was over, and the angels spoke in one voice. And they also played videos of people on their knees begging God for mercy, and people crying and begging to save our country and to prevent all the bloodshed, and people who love peace praying for peace from God. And that this trial is ongoing, and it is affected by your prayers and by the things that you say. And the things that we say have so much power that when we speak on earth, things happen in heaven. Our voices are being heard before the throne of God in this heavenly courtroom as we indict each other with wishes of death upon each other. And meanwhile, the rest of us are holding back the tide of war by praying for peace in our country. So that's my powerful dream. Tell me what you think of it. Was it a message from God about how we should conduct ourselves in this time of trouble? Or did I just eat too many beans? You let me know. God save our republic.